Hola! In this video, you will learn how to woo your Spanish lover using a Spanish dub of the huge Netflix hit, Bridgerton. First, we will watch the scene with subtitles. Then, we will go over the scene together and explore the main vocabulary words and their meaning. Finally, we will watch the scene again without subtitles. ¿Listos para aprender español romántico? Let's go!
No puedo dejar de pensar en ti. De las mañanas que aligeras, a las noches que tranquilizas, a los sueños que habitas. Mis pensamientos de ti no cesan. Soy tuyo, Daphne. Siempre he sido tuyo.
Yo no lo entiendo.
No sé cómo podría ser más claro.
Bueno, no te enojes.
No estoy enojado, yo...
Te ves enojado y molesto, hasta estás sonrojado.
Sí, esto es lo que pasa.
Cuando alguien se
enoja... Cuando alguien se quema por otro que no siente lo mismo.
¿Tú te quemas por mí?
¿Por qué crees que te perseguí hasta aquel jardín?
¿Por qué crees que yo fui a ese jardín? Si tan solo me hubieras mirado... Esta semana, por más de 2 segundos, lo habrías notado. Eres tú al que no quiero sacrificar. Yo me quemo por ti.
Let's now dive into the scene and break down the main vocabulary words.
No puedo dejar de pensar en ti.
No puedo dejar de pensar en ti. I can't stop thinking about you. In Spanish, déjalo, from the verb dejar, means to leave. However, it can also be used as stop. You might hear someone say, déjalo, as in, stop it. In this case, we see the Duke telling Daphne that he can't stop thinking about her. No puede dejar de pensar en ella.
De las mañanas que aligeras.
De las mañanas que aligeras. Of the mornings you lighten. Mañanas is the word for mornings. However, you won't hear anyone saying buena mañana, as in good morning. In Spanish, we typically say buenos días, good day. Aligeras comes from the verb aligerar, which means to make something less heavy. So, in this romantic phrase, the Duke is saying that he can't stop thinking of the mornings that Daphne makes lighter. Las mañanas que aligeras.
A las noches que tranquilizas.
A las noches que tranquilizas. To the nights that you calm. Tranquilizas comes from the verb tranquilizar, which means to calm someone or something down. Remember, in Spanish, the S termination of a verb indicates tú or you are doing the action. For example, you shine, brillas. We're going to keep all our examples pretty romantic today. In the clip, the Duke of Hastings is telling Daphne that she calms his nights. Tú calmas mis noches.
A los sueños que habitas.
A los sueños que habitas. To the dreams you inhabit. Oh, is there a more romantic line than this one? Habitas comes from the verb habitar, meaning to inhabit. Instead of just saying that he dreams of her, the Duke is saying that Daphne inhabits his dreams. Habitas mis sueños. It sounds way more romantic.
Mis pensamientos de ti no cesan.
Mis pensamientos de ti no cesan. My thoughts of you never cease. This line is very similar to I can't stop thinking about you. No puedo dejar de pensar en ti. The meaning is similar, but this one comes off as slightly more intense. Cesan comes from the verb cesar, meaning to stop. It's not a very common expression today, but it's very appropriate for Bridgerton's era. Cesar is an uncommon word and you might not be sure how to use it. A dictionary will only show you the definition, but you want to know how to add it in your daily conversations. If we click on the word in FluentU, you not only get a full definition, but also examples, a recording of the pronunciation, and related words. Let's watch another example on FluentU.
Este es un romo que brilla sin cesar.
On FluentU, you can rewind, repeat, and enjoy all you want. There's a huge selection of videos that you can easily choose from. Music videos, YouTube videos, movie scenes, TED Talks, and more. Click on the link below and sign up for a free trial today.
Soy tuyo, Daphne. Siempre he sido tuyo.
Soy tuyo, Daphne. Siempre he sido tuyo. I am yours, Daphne. I've always been yours. Another appropriate way to say soy tuyo would also be te pertenezco. I belong to you. Pertenecer means belong.
Yo no lo entiendo.
No sé cómo podría ser más claro.
Yo no lo entiendo. No sé cómo podría ser más claro. I don't understand. I don't know how I could be any clearer. No sé cómo podría is conjugated and conditional, as the Duke is saying he doesn't know what he could possibly do to be more clear. In this case, poder means to be able or have the capacity to do something. For example, no podría amarte más. I could not love you more. Hey, I told you we would be going deep with the romantic examples.
Bueno, no te enojes.
No estoy enojado.
Bueno, no te enojes. No estoy enojado. Well, don't get mad. I am not angry. Enojado is a word that can be used to express both mad and angry. However, you can also use the word enfadado. They both mean the same thing.
Te ves enojado y molesto, hasta estás sonrojado.
Sí, esto es lo que pasa.
Te ves enojado y molesto, hasta estás sonrojado. Sí, eso es lo que pasa. You look angry and upset, even flushed. Yes, this is what happens. We talked about how the word enojado means mad or angry. The word molesto can mean something very similar and can also be used as you would use the word upset. It doesn't always relate to anger. Sometimes people feel sad and upset. Me siento triste y molesta. Daphne is telling the Duke he looks angry and upset. To prove this, she points out that he looks sonrojado, meaning flushed.
Cuando
alguien se quema por otro que no siente lo mismo.
Cuando alguien se enoja. Cuando alguien se quema por otro que no siente lo mismo. When someone gets angry. When someone burns for someone else who doesn't feel the same. Now, the Duke admits he's not flushed because he's angry. He's flushed because he's burning for someone who doesn't feel the same. Se quema por otro que no siente lo mismo. They are conjugating the verbs in third person, he, she, because they are referring to someone. That's what happens when someone burns. Eso pasa cuando alguien se quema. Now, saying you burn for someone or se quema por otro is not the most common thing. However, it means you are hurting and longing over someone. It means you are dying for someone. Me muero por ti.
¿Tú te quemas por mí?
¿Tú te quemas por mí? Do you burn for me? Again, te quemas por mí is a very intense expression. And there might be other ways for you to convey the same thing. For example, me derrito por ti. I melt for you.
¿Por qué crees que te perseguí hasta aquel jardín?
¿Por qué crees que te perseguí hasta aquel jardín? Why do you think I chased you into that garden? Perseguí, from the verb perseguir, means to follow or chase. Aquel is a Spanish demonstrative meaning that. However, it is used to point out to something that is at a further distance. Words like perseguir can be tough to remember. To make sure you don't forget all the words we've learned today, we've made you a free PDF of all the vocabulary that you can get by clicking on the link in the description below.
¿Por qué crees que yo fui a ese jardín?
¿Por qué crees que yo fui a ese jardín? Why do you think I went to that garden? In Spanish, there are three ways to say why, por qué. An easy tip is to remember that when it is used in a question, it should always be separate and carry an accent. Daphne is asking the Duke why he thinks she went into the garden in the first place. He doesn't quite realize she was hoping to meet him there.
Si tan solo me hubieras mirado esta semana, por más de 2 segundos lo habrías notado. Eres tú al que no quiero sacrificar.
Si tan solo me hubieras mirado esta semana, por más de 2 segundos, lo habrías notado. Eres tú al que no quiero sacrificar. If you had just looked at me this week for more than 2 seconds, you would have noticed. It's you I don't want to sacrifice. This is a tricky expression. If you look at the words alone, you might read something like, yes, so alone. But that's not quite right. Si tan solo is an expression that means if only, or, as Daphne uses it, if you had just. It is often used to wonder what would have happened if, or what would happen if something had been different. Si tan solo me hubieras mirado esta semana por más de 2 segundos, lo habrías notado. It's exactly that. Daphne is wondering what would have happened if the Duke had paid attention to her that week. Eres tú al que no quiero sacrificar. It's you I don't want to sacrifice. Another way to say something similar to this would be no quiero perderte. I don't want to lose you.
Yo me quemo por ti.
Yo me quemo por ti. I burn for you. And the final, romantic and intense, me quemo por ti. Another way to say this could also be me consumo por ti. I'm consumed by you. Okay, ready? It's time to watch the full clip again without subtitles.
No puedo dejar de pensar en ti. De las mañanas que aligeras, a las noches que tranquilizas, a los sueños que habitas. Mis pensamientos de ti no cesan. Soy tuyo, Daphne. Siempre he sido tuyo.
Yo no lo entiendo.
No sé cómo podría ser más claro.
Bueno, no te enojes.
No estoy enojado, yo...
Te ves enojado y molesto, hasta estás sonrojado.
Sí, esto es lo que pasa.
Cuando alguien se
enoja... Cuando alguien se quema por otro que no siente lo mismo.
¿Tú te quemas por mí?
¿Por qué crees que te perseguí hasta aquel jardín?
¿Por qué crees que yo fui a ese jardín? Si tan solo me hubieras mirado esta semana, por más de 2 segundos lo habrías notado. Eres tú al que no quiero sacrificar. Yo me quemo por ti.
If you want to continue learning Spanish and enjoy this kind of videos, check out this video where we will be breaking down another scene from a hit Netflix show. I'll see you there.